probably all heard of Bowler. It's the company that made something called the Wildcat, a crazy Paris-Dakar rally raid machine that looked like a Land Rover Defender, well, on the outside at least. It delivered its first car in 1986. Now, Bowler doesn't make the Wildcat anymore. It makes something called the EXR. We're going to drive it today. But Bowler's customers have shown an interest in having an EXR for the road. And this is the development car for that project, the EXRS. And it has 550 horsepower. Just look at the thing.
I'm here with Ed Cobley, who is an off-road driving guru who knows more about these things than most people and how to drive them. So first of all, I'll ask him a bit about the spec of the car, and then I want him to tell me how I should apply my knowledge of that mechanical layout to driving the car. So first of all, we've got the standard sort of Jaguar Land Rover supercharged V8. Yep. How much horsepower?
This is running about 550 horsepower at the moment.
How much torque?
About 700 pound-feet of torque.
So it's enough?
It's enough.
And we reckon 1,700 kilograms?
Around 1,730, I think, is about the exact number, yeah.
Okay, so it's on, at the moment, it's on a street tyre,
yep.
But we've got an off-road type suspension.
An off-road suspension. We're just looking at refining the suspension at the moment for the on-road market. We've got the off-road market wrapped up, really, with the suspension. So it's just something we're dialing at the moment, looking at different manufacturers. So it's very much driven in an orientation of a very reactive manner, almost like a rally style at the moment, in the way we drive the car.
So torque splits, four-wheel drive,
yep.
Permanent four-wheel drive.
Yep.
We've got a locking diff at the rear and a locking diff in the middle.
Exactly that. So we can have a torque split of 50 to the front, 50 to the back, and then an equal distribution, 25 at the rear each. So it really makes it quite drivable on an oversteered situation.
So is it 50-50 lock the whole time?
This one actually is, yeah. The race car is a 60-40 power split, and this is a 50-50 split.
Okay. This incredible little private venue we're at, which we can't say where we are, but it's beautiful. However, it's about as fraught with danger as anywhere I've ever been. We've got a nice water hazard in the middle, and we've got immovable objects in the form of trees and rocky banks that were on the outside. And we're kind of hoping to let this thing move around a bit. So I am, it has to be said, shitting myself because it's expensive. And actually, I'm quite expensive as well, so I don't want to hurt myself. So we're looking to maybe have some attitude of the car before the apex.
Exactly.
Gas and drive it through.
Exactly. I think the old saying is a Scandinavian flick, do I believe, right?
In a 1,700 kilogram, 700 foot-pound of torque,
yeah.
SUV on street tyres.
That's fine.
Yeah. Mental, mate. In drive, it drives like a normal automatic. We've got no interior here, this is a development car, but I've got a Range Rover steering wheel. Pulls away quite nicely. Lots of good engine noise, burbling, bubbling. I'm sitting high. I haven't got much steering feel. I've got a normal Pirelli street tyre on there, running a 21-inch rim. And driven like this, on this rather technical little circuit, it feels fine. It feels quite pleasant, then it feels quite pokey. What it doesn't prepare you for is what happens when you push a little bit harder. We've come to this little bottom corner here now, and I'll use a bit more throttle. And then all bloody hell breaks loose. That's 90, 100, 110, 120, 125. This is one of the silliest cars I've ever driven. You can back it into corners. There's hints of oversteer everywhere. I've got more yaw than you get on a cross-channel ferry in a Force 9 gale. It's remarkable. It's got immense traction too, immense traction. Look at my surroundings. I'm effectively in someone's garden where there just happens to be a small racetrack. What a thing, what a place! Oversteer on the crest at 85. I'll tell you what, for 155 grand, there aren't going to be many rivals to this thing. Look at that, flipping oversteer. Oversteer in third gear. you get that in a G-Wagon? Don't think you do. This must be the most niche vehicle of all niches. It really is for people that find a G63 or a G65 just a little bit lacking in performance. So if you own a diamond mine, and that's what you want to do, you want to get to work and back as fast as possible, then this is your vehicle. Let's think about the driving style for a minute. Ed is fairly specific about the way you've got to back the car in. You need to back it in before the corner. So you just back it in there. Car wants to oversteer, get on the gas, and it follows you round. The problem I have is that there is a bit of a sort of oversteer window to get through. And to judge that, how much circuit you need to let the car wash out, it's quite difficult here. Of course, it's quite narrow and I don't want to clout something, but this is bonkers. Absolutely bonkers. Never experienced anything, I have to say, quite like it. 1.7 tonnes with full oversteer in someone's back garden. This thing is a proper bit of kit. You just can't believe the way it handles the bumps. Oversteer everywhere. You sort of try and look for a bit of a racing line. Oh, there's a pheasant. He's gonna get it. Take speed off of these slower corners, but it's quite rear biased. It's just drifting everywhere. The thing weighs 1950 kilograms, but that's with 400 litres of fuel on board. I've driven in a while.
We need to go and do a rally raid, Neil. This is awesome, this thing. It just feels like a big, slightly cumbersome rally car, you know? But it wants to move around, it wants to oversteer, and again, with these off-road vehicles, what your eyes tell you is coming up, the vehicle never transmits to you. You just can't believe the way it deals with the bumps and everything else. Wow. Please excuse my ridiculous seating position. A 6'5" German was in here before me, but that is awesome. Absolutely awesome. Woo!
It isn't mainstream then, the EX-RS, but there isn't much like it out there because it isn't even a G63 rival. It's a potential rally raid winner with a trimmed interior. Oh, and 550 horsepower. And as of June 2012, it's kind of semi-official. Much like Mercedes had an agreement with AMG in the 90s before buying it, Land Rover is now working to help Bowler. All the EX-RS needs now is a proper name, like, Growler, that's it. The Bowler Growler. Like it.